morning. Good morning, Warriors on a Mission. I thank God, as I always say, that we're here to gather and to be able to just express and our love and joy and all the things of God. I thank God because our Father is awesome. I don't know how much time you've been spending just with God, because if you do, it's going to bless your life. What do I mean by that? I'm not saying just coming to church. I'm not saying about, you know, the things that we do automatically think about as far as on a religious standpoint of coming to church and Bible study. I'm saying when you spend your intimate time with God, it will bless your life. It will change your thought process. It will elevate you, because God is about elevation. I'm not talking about natural. Yeah, he will give you promotion and jobs and all that stuff. But what God is trying to do is elevate us in the spirit, to get us out of ourselves and all of the things that we used to be as a baby. And God's really about that, because if you think about the days, every day you get older, God is so awesome, because every day we actually get older, and somehow we've taken that to be as a negative. But I thank God that I'm no longer the babe I used to be, the baby, the whiny baby, the toddler, the one that had to have everything his way. And you say, okay, that's maturity. But look, I'm telling you, I didn't really necessarily like school, especially my earlier years. So by the time my last few years, I really enjoyed myself. Why is that important? Because those years that I didn't like school, I would hate to be stuck there. So I thank God that he does allow us to get older every day. But that's our Father. So when you spend time with God, God begins to elevate your thought process. He begins to feed you and teach you about spiritual things, and it'll bless your life. And so I thank God, that's why when we come together, it's important to me that we do, because I know God's going to feed not only me, but he feeds you. And yes, I do really on purpose try to spend time with God, whether I'm driving, working, or out in the yard, or working on a vehicle, whatever it is that I'm doing, I'm literally trying to get it for God, because when I do, it blesses me. It relieves me of all the pain and stress of the day, and most of the pain is up here. And so I thank God that he allows me to have an access of relief, and it's him. It's a safe space. It's a real safe space. Anything good? Okay, it's a real safe space. And you know, as human beings, we're always looking for a safe space. And oftentimes, somehow, when we make our list of people that brings us a safe space, we leave God out as number one. And then we wonder why it don't work out. You know, we got all the cliches about, you know, be careful if they bring you a bone and take a bone and all that stuff. But guess what? Oftentimes, if you're just going to God, you don't even have to release it to another human being, because God will give you the peace you need, and he provides the answer. And when you don't have an answer, you have the peace of knowing I can just trust my Father, and he's going to lead me where I need to go. So pray for that bless you. Guess what? That's what God is about. I'm telling you. He's not about giving you miserable days. He's not about that. Yeah, not every day is going to be rainbows and sunshines, as my wife likes to say. But what he does do, he will give you the peace that you're able to sit back and ride going through your journey. And now I'm not stressed out on the inside, because I just trust my Father. Again, while it's so important that we need to spend time with our Father, just learning how to rest in his presence. And guess what? He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. So if my Father's on the inside, guess what? We can't leave his presence, which means I don't have to worry about being alone. I don't have to worry about leading the show. I don't have to worry about knowing my next move, because my Father's always on the inside, because I've asked him to be there. That's what salvation was about. And so because now I learned how to get out of the driver's seat and let him drive, I don't have to always know where I'm going. A lot of times I want to know, because that's the human side of me. But the fact of the matter is, when I don't know where I'm going, it's okay, because I know my Father knows where I'm going. He knows he steps of a righteous man is ordered by God. It always comes up. And so the more you meditate on that scripture right there, the steps of a righteous man is ordered by God, you'll find out that, guess what? Where you are is where God intended for you to be. It doesn't mean we love it. It doesn't mean we like it. But when you understand that God is actually moving you in a direction that he has ordained, which means you're right where you're supposed to be. I thank God for that. So before we go any further, we're going to go into prayer. And it's just you and I today, and my son, he's recording. And so we're just kind of going to do this thing on a personal level. That's where we started. And so I thank God that, again, we are still able to move forward, because a lot of people had a lot of stuff going on this weekend, and that's fine. I understand that. That is cool, because at the end of the day, God said he'll bring who He'll bring the ones that he wants to have. And I'm fine with that. And that's the powerful thing of a lens. What I have learned by watching the views, there's been very few times that I've had the exact same amount of numbers sitting in an audience versus those that view online. So either way, I'm not even worried about that. But let us go on to pray. So Father, I thank you, Lord, for this awesome day, God. This present day that you blessed us to be able to enjoy, that you have decorated, you have ordained. Father, you've left your presence each and every day, God, for us to just enjoy. I thank you, Father, that even though I might not recognize it all, I'm more aware of the things you give us to just enjoy on a daily basis. And God, I thank you, Lord, that you allow us to understand this by your Spirit. Today is always a great day, God, because you ordained it. So thank you, Father. Thank you for giving us a day to enjoy. And now I thank you for this day because it's the one we're standing in. Lord, you are awesome. You are wonderful. You are every single thing that we ever need, God. Thank you for not leaving us in a fallen state, but you prepared a way for us to get back to you by Jesus Christ. So God, I thank you, Lord, that this thing really is not confusing if we'll spend time with you. God, you'll break it down in such a way that the smallest can understand. And my sister-in-law was saying, out of the mouth of babes, God, I thank you that you know how to speak to our children. So if you speak to our children and break it down at a young age, God, I know you'll break it down to us. Here we are, 37, 44, 45, 60. God, you know how to break it down. So God, I thank you so much for you just being you. And even allowing us to get to know you. Thank you, Lord. For it is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hey, God got a word for the day. God is going to bless you. It's already coming out already. I don't know if you know. Recognize the scripture that God gave us on today. But it's already taking root. So here we are. We're going to listen to the first song that God gave us. And enjoy. Amen.
Savior, come on, bless me. Ain't no need for stressing in my life. Money and missing my full purpose. Yeah, but I know I'm protected by the blood, protected by the love. God, grace and mercy, all his favor. Save me higher, just rise that favor. And every time I turn, we'll be right back.
funny, I remember us saying, and we kind of use it as a cliche, like, look at God, but that's for real. If you actually spend the time looking at God, right, God bless you, man, it'll have you in a place where you just like, man, there you go again. I feel another blessing. Look at God. And so, what better place to be in? That's why scripture tells us the joy of the Lord is our strength. When you got your eyes on Jesus or you got your eyes on the Father, it's like, guess what? You start to see him everywhere. You start seeing him in nature. You start seeing him in commercials. And you start seeing him in vehicles riding by. When you see the bumper stickers. But guess what? As a truck driver, I pay attention to a lot of small factors, right? Like when I'm driving and I see a little kid looking at me and just smiling, wait, that's God. That is God right there. Because guess what? I get a whole lot of people look at me or either won't look at me but give me the bird. As my brother says, that's the I love you finger. So I get that too. So guess what? I know when God is showing up in a human being. Sometimes it's an adult. It ain't always a kid. They just look and smile. Man, that's God. That's God. Look at God. And so when I see that, it reminds me, it carries my day over for another hour or two. Well, I'm just enjoying his presence and enjoying his day. And so, excuse me, it's that thought process. If you start to have that, you start dreading the day and dreading the next hour or dreading that next minute or just having a mood where it's like, man, all I'm doing is existing. Well, guess what? God has you existing for a purpose. And if you're willing to allow God to come in and change your perspective, you will start to enjoy your days. I get it. Listen, you hear us talk about it all the time here on Words on a Mission. It's a battle between the spirit and the soul. It's always going to be that way. So when you understand it's just like temptation when it comes out of the soul's realm, you're always going to have temptation. And I used to think, not knowing, my people perish from a lack of knowledge, right? So I used to think that the temptation meant I sinned. Because I was tempted meant I sinned. And then one day God enlightened me on an old song that I used to hear in my mama's original home church, Fat Rock, that is sin. And one day God kind of like blew that verse up in my mind, and I saw it for the first time as God sees it. It's not the temptation that is the sin. We're tempted all day long because that's what we live in, a body. That body and that soul's room has a constant pull and fight with your spirit, the spirit of God that's in you. And so that temptation is just like, it's just like having bad communication, or having that friend that's in your ear that's always trying to tell you to do something stupid. That's what that soul's room is like. It's constantly trying to pull you into wrong, into evil, into doing the things against God. And your spirit is constantly trying to pull you to the things of God. It's just like back in the day when they had those TV shows and those cartoons where you had God and the devil on one side and you hear one talking in one ear and another. That's what's going on in your spirit. That's what's going on, excuse me, that's what's going on the inside of you, because what's happening is the soul is always trying to get you to disobey God, and God's like, hey, no, come on, this is the better way. Come on, this is the better way. But God being God, he's not going to force you. He gives us freedom of choice. So y'all know, if you've been around for a while, sometimes we've taken the wrong, we listen to the wrong one, and then here we are sitting in some sort of catastrophe. And now we're begging God. We're like, God, help, help. God's like, I'm trying to tell you, man. Just come on. I got you. Come on. And so, listen. It's the enemy, the inner me, the inner I-N-N-E-R me, the soul's realm that's always trying to get you to feel bad about your decisions, to try to make you, listen, after you've done it, all you can do is repent. But the enemy will have you, your soul's realm will have you reliving the stupid choice over and over again. And here you are 5, 10 years down the road, and it's like you're still thinking about it as if you just did it 2 months ago or 2 days ago. That's not God. And so I thank God for that sort of elevation within me, as we talked about spiritual maturity before. I thank God for it, because guess what? There was a point in time in my life where the enemy won. The soul's realm in my, the soul's realm won. The enemy won in my life, because I would sit there and rehearse every bad decision. And now I miss out on all the good presence that God has left for me in that day, because I'm so distracted on the garbage that I'm listening to the inner me, soul shrimp, tell me and remind me about myself. I wasn't putting enough God time in for God to remind me of where he's taking me. I was allowing my soul shrimp to take me back to what I have done when I didn't know that. And so I thank God that once again, spending time with him is what's elevated me to the state that I am now, where I have more peace, more joy, more love to give. Listen, I see a lot of people, one thing that I've learned in the spirit realm, and we thought it was the thing to do right back in the day, right? Like the more cold-faced and just mean you look, you was actually some psychological craziness. We thought we were elevated on some sort of scale. So the harder you walk, you know what I'm saying? The meaner you look, you thought you was bad. And guess what? In most cases, I was the most tender on the inside at that moment that I am with a smile on my face and joy in my heart. And so now I thank God that he elevated me out of that craziness, that thought process that kept me down by the thoughts that had to make me look crazy on the face or make me walk a certain way to make me look like I was somebody. But guess what? What I've learned now in the point that I'm at in my life, the more I allow God to shine through, there's a lot of people that are hurting. And guess what? Seeing you with a smile on your face elevates them out of their pain. Seeing you with a smile and a hug elevates them out of the pain that they're enduring. And so thank God that these are presents of God that he gives us every day for us to edify one another with just a smile. I'm telling you, it does wonders. And when you spend time with God, you begin to see these type of things happen all the time where you see some lady or man that's older and they remind you of a loved one that's gone on. And for some apparent reason, they'll look at you and smile and wave. That's God. Look at God. Look at God. So guess what? Just enjoy what God is doing. But it takes a mindset to get out of all of the running and craziness that soul and spirit provides. What you going to do next? What you going to do about this? What you going to do? That ain't God. But when you start getting to God, I'm going to let God have it, man. I'm not even trying to think about tomorrow. But as the word of God says, hey, tomorrow will take care of itself. God already got that. So what I'm going to do is just enjoy where I'm at right now. I'm going to enjoy it. And I promise you, at first, it is a conscious decision to do it. Amen? It's a conscious decision. But after a while, it gets to a point where, man, I ain't thinking about that. Man, what about that? Hey, listen, if you want to keep coming to me about what it is, I can tell you, I'm going to trust God. And guess what? You have a great day, sir. So that's how you do that. And so anyway, I thank God that he's preserving our peace. And he's always done it. But it's up for us. And now he's enlightened me on how to preserve the peace by basically just staying in his presence. Just remembering the things of God and being walking in his righteousness. Not walking in the meanness and things of the world, but just enjoy him. Just allow God to be me. You know what God gave me, dropped this in my spirit, I think about 2 days ago. The most purest form of God is looking at a baby. You watch a child. The most purest form of God is looking at a little child and how joyful they are for no reason at all. I mean, it is a blessing. I used to hear older people talk like that, right? But because of all the thoughts and the rat races that we say back in the day that I was in, I couldn't witness it. But when you pay attention to a child, man, they are we're made in God's image. So that is the closest form of God. Like, when a child just run up to you, they're not trying to act no certain way. It's just pure love. They just run up to you and hug you, and they hug you as tight as they can possibly hug you. And I'm telling you, it's a blessing when you start to pay attention to those things, because at some point in my life, I saw things like that as something else for me to have to take care of. A duty, not the presence. Not the presence of God. And so, once again, a lot of things pulled out right there, but if any of those things you can kind of relate to, listen to what God is trying to show you. I'm telling you, God is not into us wallowing in pain. That's not him. That's not him. And I'm going to tell you this. And you've heard me share this on several times on Warriors on a Mission, because I have lived through it. The longer you wallow in pain in the natural, the longer you wallow in pain in the spirit, while you allow the enemy, the soul's room, to take over, it won't be long before your natural body begins to hurt. Amen? How do I know? Stress leads to a headache. Amen? Stress leads to heart pain, chest pain, heart attacks. And so just two examples. But God is showing us it is a spiritual thing first. And then eventually it is manifest in the natural in your body. And so I'm telling you, not pointing fingers at nobody, because I had to start with me. God showed me first. And now because I lived through it, and God had to speak this word to me, and I thank you. If you're watching this, I still appreciate your obedience, evangelist Gloria Irvin. I appreciate you, because I have never been told or taught that until that moment when you told me that. And so then God enlightened my mind. And I don't know if my son got something he want to share or not. If he does, great. I'll let him do his thing. If he don't have anything to share, then we're going to keep moving on. Amen. So bear with me for a little bit. Get ready to hear this next song.
When you become a believer, the spirit is made right. Sometimes the soul doesn't get to know it. You have to hold it. But due to things that's happened in the past, hurt, abuse, or molestation, we want to speak to this and tell this. That God wants to heal the hope in your soul. Sometimes it's actually not because of their spirit. But it's because of the past that's left a hole in your soul. May this wisdom help you get over yourself and remind you that God wants to heal a hole in your soul. When you have my sister Leandria here, she's going to come to share this wisdom and tell this story.
Bye.
speaking for all of you listening, starting here, starting now. The things that hurt you in the past won't control your future. Starting now, this is a new day. This is your essence. You are officially released. Now sing it for the end.
Right one in your life. Amen. So I just took us down. But guess what? It's some meat in that message. There's a lot of meat in that message. So if you're willing to let God do what he does, amen, you'll get the better outcome than you trying to drive. I had to learn it the hard way. I promise you, I learned the hard way. So trust me. Trust God and lead not to thine own understanding, but in all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct thy path. Amen? All right. So, son, I said I was going to give you the opportunity. Do you have anything you want to share?
I thank God for getting me through the week despite being sick and having headaches.
I love it. You know what? It was so awesome. I know you could hear him. You didn't see him. But I thank God because even this morning, as I was meditating and going into what God has for us on today, God began to say, he said something to his mama. His mama asked him how was he feeling, and he was talking about, excuse me, y'all, for those that feel that's vulgar, mucus. And he said when he came home, he stayed in the restroom to get the mucus out of his system. And God began to share me something in my spirit. He began to show me something that oftentimes God will keep you in the dumping spot to get the mess out of your system. What does that mean? Sometimes he'll keep you stagnant. He'll keep you right in a place that you don't want to be at. But he knows by keeping you in that place, it's going to make you get rid of that stuff that's hurting you. Remember, we just talked about control. Sometimes God will keep you in a spot so that you can get rid of, you can regurgitate that mess, that garbage that's poisoning you from the inside. And so God will, you like that, so like I'm praying. And he's like, I heard you. I'm going to get you out. But I know this thing goes deeper than what you know. And so I'm keeping you in this spot just for a little bit longer, just for you to get all that poisonous thought, all that poisonous spirit has to be healed. And I know being God, this is God now saying, I know what it takes. So God will keep you in the dumping ground, that hardcore wilderness spot, just for you to regurgitate and say, guess what? I don't want to hold on to it no more. Here's all of that mess, God. I know I used it as a crutch before, but that crutch is no longer necessary. Your crutch is much stronger than the mess I've been holding through or was given back in the day. Because guess what? Oftentimes, spirits was given to us, and we didn't even understand what we was receiving. Man, I saw a post talking about fornication the other day. And oftentimes we thought that mindset, first of all, was given to us from somebody that didn't even know any better. And then we took our bodies through the situation of allowing someone else to impart spirits into us. Listen. I told people that this is going to be funny, and I don't know if this is TMI, too much information or not. But I told my wife, I said, you never about nobody else because I ain't got time. I don't know what's in you. I'm used to what's in my wife. My wife is used to what's in me. Amen. I don't want to mess with nobody else and get involved. Now, next thing I know, I'm sitting outside howling at the moon. I had my brother laughing at that because you're worshiping the moon and all those other stars. No. I walk around and scratch it behind my ears, not because of fleas. But I done took on some spirit that is just dominating. You got to be careful. And that's some real stuff right here. You got to be careful who you allow to be in your space and who you allow to impart their spirit into you, whether it's constant, you allowing them to pastor you. And I'm telling you, they constantly got advice for you. And you calling them for advice. You know, I'm in a relationship. My mama made me mad, or my daddy made me mad. They just don't understand. And then you allow them to pastor you and give you some advice that ain't got it. Now they became your pastor. You allow them to impart spirits into you just by listening to the garbage that is coming out of their mouth. Or maybe it's some show, and it's your favorite talk show. But you can look at them and say, they're not a child of God. They ain't trying to walk like a child of God. But you turn on to them and you record it faithfully. Guess what? You just appointed them to be your pastor. And so now they impart stuff into your spirit that is only poisoning you with from the inside out. And you're wondering why now you just got some negative feelings towards a group of people. Or you got negative feelings towards this and negative feelings towards that. And you can look at it and analyze and say, that ain't of God. But yet still, you go back and let them pastor you every single moment. And you catch up because they got a marathon. Or you maybe got 15 shows that you recorded. And you let them pastor you. And and speak into your spirit, and it drop all this dump, and dump all this stuff into your spirit, and now you can't sleep. Man, I'm telling you, been there, done that. And so I thank God that He has elevated our minds once again to a place to let us know when it's time of God, when we need to run, when we need to stay. And it's because of the Holy Spirit, when we stop trying to control everything, that we actually listen to the Holy Spirit and actually obey God when He speaks. Amen. Or at least try. That's the starting point. God will take your trying and bless it because He sees you at least as giving Him room in your heart. Amen. Well, you're like, I ain't trying to hit that, God. I can do this, man. That's why I trusted you. Somebody died. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. So guess what? What happens is we allow the enemy, and we allow the soul's room to tell us, because of pain, I don't want to experience it again. God, you did me wrong because that caused me pain. Guess what? Anybody with a heartbeat, y'all know the story. Eventually it stops. But you got to know how to look at that thing through the perspective of God. To be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. If they knew God, they with God, they got a celebration going on. Yes, it's us that got to mourn and go through the cycle of pain. And guess what? Back in the day, Old Testament, you look at the Old Testament, it gave them a month to mourn. A month. But here we are trying to get rid of it in 7 days. Or we trying to suck it up and move on to 3 days. It's okay to go through the process. Just don't get stuck there. But then when you go through the process of mourning and understanding, they're good. And now I got to ask God to help me pick up the pieces and move on. God, this is the hardest thing maybe I've ever had to deal with. But I need you to help me through this. And God said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. Take your hand, put it in mine. Take your trust and put it in me. Take your faith and put it in me. And I'm going to lead you and guide you. And I will fulfill the void. I'll be the mother, the father, the cup, whatever void that you have. It could be your pet. I'll be the one that will give you the peace if you allow me to. All right? So anyway, here's the word that God's given us for today. I have to write the passage. I mean, the title down. Sometimes I'll be forgetting the title. I have to ask my wife, what is it? But this is the title that God gave us. You are better today than you were on yesterday. Amen. This is the title God gave us. You're better today than you were on yesterday. And this is coming from Psalms, the 37th chapter, verse 23. It is a passage of scripture. Like I said before, God was already moving on this thing. So it's a passage of scripture, that God has already spoken this morning. And it says, the steps of a righteous man is ordered by the Lord, and he delights in his ways. Now, so when you understand, because this is what God is constantly pouring out, the steps of a righteous man is ordered by God, and he delights in his ways. What that is saying, once again, as you hear us talk about it, God has already ordered your steps. God has already ordered your steps. He has already, from the moment in time that you was in the womb, understand, God had before, matter of fact, before you got in the womb, God already had a plan for you to get here. How do I know He did the same thing for Jesus? It was prophesied throughout the Old Testament, long before Jesus got here, there's going to be from the lineage of David. There's going to be from the lineage of David. You heard this repeatedly thousands of years before Jesus came. So you and I are made in God's image. God has a purpose for every single one of us long before mom and daddy met, long before grandparents met, long before, at the beginning of the world, God had a purpose for you getting here. You look in the mirror. Go look in the mirror and say to yourself, I am anointed and appointed by God for this season. The enemy wants you to think something different, but God ordained for you to be here. You couldn't have gotten here 20 years before. You couldn't have gotten here 5 days before. You had to get here at the appointed time of birth for you to be effective for the job, the purpose that God put you here for. And so when you start understanding that God isn't not scratching his head like, I wonder what I'm going to do now. I guess I'll know. That's not our Father. He's Alpha and Omega. He's all-knowing. There's so many names. He has El Shaddai, Elohim. There's so many names of our Father because He is the great I Am. Fill in the blank. He is that. And so when you start understanding that, then you understand that where you are today, where you are today, the steps of a righteous man is ordered by God. Where you are today is where you're supposed to be. And if you look at your process, it says you are better today than you were yesterday. You look at the process of life that you've experienced. Where you are today, you're far better than you were yesterday. Your mind don't even operate the same. What you did on yesterday was preparing you for today. Literally. Now you can add the amount of days that you want to add in your column for yesterday. But even yesterday prepared you for today. 24 hours ago prepared you for 24 hours later. But your yesterday, all of the days, the years prior, it prepared you for the moment. And guess what? Your future is all connected to your past. God has used every single moment and season in your life to prepare you for your journey. To prepare you for your purpose. That's our Father. That's our Father. I promise you. He did not. You said, well, what about the pain? What about what I endured? You endured it. You didn't die in it. But he used that pain to help you mature in the area that you to heal other people. God, see, we always think about healing as coming out of the medicine cabinet. We think all to the day, all the healing we can get is standing in line for a prescription or standing in the emergency room or sitting there for a consultation. But God's trying to heal you spiritually. And guess what? If he heals you spiritually, it's going to work out in the natural. God showed me something. He reminded me this morning that your brain, your memory that you have is only for this earth. That brain is only for this earth. So that's why you can't remember things that happened before, but your spirit does. There are times when you're sitting back and all of a sudden it's not something you've experienced, but you know down in your spirit what it means. You can't put a finger on it. You never went through it. But your spirit has given you peace when you had a vision of something. That's your spirit. How do I know? Because we're made in God's image. God is a spirit, and they that worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. The only thing this brain is good for is down here. That's why it doesn't go up there. So when you're sitting up trying to remember and you're like, well, I don't understand how God's going to work it that way. You don't have to understand. Just know your spirit already knows, hey, we're connected to the source. Don't worry about brain power. I ain't never seen it this way. Yeah, you have it. But your spirit knows because your spirit has been put in you by God. And they've been hanging out for a long time. And they already like, man, chill out, God got it. Chill out, man, God got it. Go to sleep, man, God got it. Stop worrying. God got it. And guess what? He does. You're better today than you were yesterday. There was a time that certain things would have took you out for weeks just for one situation or one phone call, one cussing out. Somebody just cussed you out, and now you for 2 months, you can't even function because you got to cuss them back out. God's like, man, come on, man. Let's go. Pray for them because they hurt worse than you are. That's what God began to show me. When God began to show me that a lot of people walking around, and we talked about this towards the beginning, when God started showing me these people, a lot of the ones that are walking around and they just look so hateful, they are in bondage. And they need the love of God. They need to express, they need to have it expressed to them. Sometimes it's just a smile. Sometimes it's a compliment. Amen? Sometimes it's a compliment. And it will break them and their light will begin to shine from the inside out. And God said, that's all I needed. I used you just for them to finally get me an open spot. I do the rest. I just needed an invitation. Oh, man. Y'all seen it before when something is so poisonous, like the bottom of it. You take some food now. I don't know what food, but I'm just going with the flow of God, right? You take some food and the top of it goes bad. But if you move the bad stuff, right, then the bottom of it is still good. And that's how our heart has been in certain situations where we've just gotten the top layer is just full because I'm tired of being hurt, so let me put on a persona that's not me. I'm the hardest thing that ever walked this earth. I'm the baddest thing in the whole time. Your heart's like, man, stop playing. Stop playing, ain't you? But you put on this persona so that you think that nobody can touch you, but when you walk up with God, they'll walk up to you, and you, I know you've seen, especially in church, especially in a real, real spot where God is doing some deliverance, you'll see that person and they're trying to fight and somebody just hug them. Yeah, brother, I know, I know, I know. And I've watched people just go. They go from, and then that's when you know that they calm down. And then you start seeing the tears begin to flow. And then you'll see them melt over somebody's shoulder. And then at the end, though, at the end, you'll see them glory, hallelujah. And you'll start seeing them praise God. And you just watched a strong transformation in somebody's life. And they'll never go back to that bondage again. That's God. What she said, going out the career hospital. Look at God. That's when you've seen the move of God, when it happens. And so God is trying to get every last one of us into that state where we just get free from the bondage. See, the wisdom of the world is foolishness. But the wisdom of God is foolishness to the world. So they think the only way I can keep you off of me, I got to put on a persona that looks like the hardest thing ever. But God's like, man, listen, I'll be your protector. Psalms 91, check it out. I'm your protector. You can enjoy my presence. You can just walk around with a smile on your face because ain't nobody going to touch you, baby. I got angels around you. Can't nobody touch you. They look at you and look the other way. And you wonder like, baby, don't do this. Don't do that, baby. Don't do this. And God said, go ahead, bro. I got you. Don't worry about that. Don't even worry. Keep that mess off your mind because you got angels all around you. You got angels in the car. You got an angel walking beside. You got angels in the door. Stuff. They got an angel sitting in your room. I got an angel in your kitchen. Matter of fact, don't even worry about it. Matter of fact, I let them go on vacation. They go with somebody else. I left one. But that's the baddest one that I got in that whole platoon. He's watching over you. And so God is like, I got you. Amen? Amen? And so, all I'm going to say to my brothers and sisters to feel like you got to have a gun with you everywhere you go, elevate. Let God be your protection. Amen? I promise you. You run out of bullets. I was in the Marine Corps. You run out of bullets. But when you grew up with God, your protection, you don't even have to worry about opening the door for them. You ain't got to prepare a spot for them to sleep. You ain't got to do none of that. God has them already moving with you. And when somebody look at you and they don't know how to act right, God will move them out of the way. Or he equipped you on how to deal with them. Amen? Because that's our Father. He's our protector. And so I say to you today, this is what God gave me. You're better than you were on yesterday. Don't worry about you yesterday. Understand God used that to build you. And he's taking you somewhere. Every single detail of your life was on purpose. Whether you thought you made a bad decision or you didn't. All things work for the good of those who do what? Love the Lord. So if you love him, right? But you just made some crazy decisions, God knows how to make it work out for your good. And so understand that you have a place you're going. You have a destination. You have a time to get there. But only God knows. We take 5 years and next thing you know, we're already sitting in retirement according to our plan. And it's 5 years later. You ain't even hit 30 yet. But in your mind, because you've been pushing, you're trying to do better than so-and-so. And God's like, man, 5 years? You funny. And you're like, but God, I got to do this. I got to do this. God's like, man, you don't have to go around for nobody. I'm still loving all my family and I can receive a little love back. Amen? And so understand that God knows what he's doing. Rest in him. Trust in him. Trust in him. Rest in him. Trust in him. Rest in him, and allow him to lead you. Amen? Let us pray. God, I thank you for once again blessing us with your word. Your word that you brought us to elevate us to a place, God, that we just trusted and rested in you. Thank you for your favor, that you are willing to impart your word and your wisdom into us. Thank you for spending time with us enough to educate us and let us know that you are right here in the midst of every situation that we're going in, on and through personally. You're there. You see it, and you're speaking a word to us to encourage us that, guess what, I'm here, baby, I got you. So thank you, Father, for all of this. I thank you, God, for just loving us enough to put a word, out. Thank you for using me, God. I can't thank you enough for that, man. Thank you so much. Thank you. And thank you, Father, that my son is here to receive it, and not only just him, but those that you have appointed to watch this Words on a Mission. I love you, Lord. You are awesome in all that you do. You are the great I am. Whether I understand what's going on or not, you're perfect. You're perfect. I got to line up. So God, thank you for it. For it is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Y'all, we're going to close out with a song. Pray if you got what you need. If you have something that you want to just inbox me or talk about or something, hey, inbox me. And, hey, man, we'll go ahead and let God do what he does. Amen. Sound like a plan? Well, it does to me. All right. Enjoy your day. We're about to close this thing out. You can jam off this one of my favorite songs.
But in the spare time, when they live the correction, we're living in a day to shoot, where everybody's drinking and ain't gonna pop. Shoot, and nobody wants to go. Shoot, we're gonna make to offend the motherfucker. We don't want to offend the youth. We don't want to offend the elders. And so therefore we crucify him afresh.
God bless you all. Have an awesome day.